truck's been in the shop for since yesterday, and we had problems paying the bill. First of all, when I first brought the truck in here, they said drop your trailer in this lot over here and drive your tractor across the street over there where we're going to do the work, right? And last night, as of last night, the truck was done at close of business yesterday. And we had problems getting the bill paid for the work that was done. And the guy, I said, well, if you don't mind, I'll sleep in my truck on the lot over there across the street. Slept out there all night. But I said, in the morning, around 3, 4, 5 in the morning, I'm going to get up and go get a shower, go get some breakfast, coffee. But I'll be back. I was like, you better not split on me. I haven't paid the bill. I said, I won't do that to you, sir. You guys got my trailer, and they do lock this gate. So, you know, and I guess, and we have just paid the bill. It's like afternoon now. It's like 1 o'clock in the afternoon. The bill's finally been paid. But I guess they put this truck here to ensure that I would not try to sneak away and steal my own trailer back. So I'm going to see if they'll move this thing. It looks like, I don't know if this thing's even drivable. Or did they push it over here with a forklift or something? I'm going to have to go ask somebody. Or do you think I can back in here at an angle to get my own trailer back? I don't think I can, because my drives are going to have to be all the way over here to swallow up that kingpin. Now, otherwise, I might be able to come in almost sideways and get it. But let me go ask. This could turn into an interesting video if they can't move this truck. Man, what a shame. Old W9 missing a hood. Maybe I'll get lucky and give me the keys.
See, I'll move it myself.
Truck right there with no hood on it. It's blocking the trailer. Is that a drivable truck, or do you have to push it in there with a forklift?
Oh.
Somebody
I'm
put
not
it.
Not the ones that work on those.
Oh. Well, I don't know who put it there then. I don't know how it ended up over there.
They move around out here all the time.
All right, bud. Appreciate your help. Damn. Insurance took a look at it and totaled it out, man. So he's gonna go find out right now how to get rid of that, move that truck out of my way. I mean, if nothing else, I will try to back in sideways to it. Super light load, it shouldn't hurt to put that sharp of a turn on the trailer tires. Soft pig. Man, it's messed up. About tempted to jump in there and see if it'll start up. Moving myself. Pat Pule. Boogity boogity. I imagine they catch a lot of wrecks out here on Interstate 40 over there in the wintertime, and the slick and the ice, and And they tow them in here and dump them off, and they strip them down for parts. They're totaled out by the insurance. But the company tow yard gets to keep what's left over, and they get to cannibalize anything that's useful. I think that's what goes on here. Did you say it drives?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay, perfect.
Probably they parked it here because they were working on something else and had to move this one.
Oh, it could be, it could be, it could be.
They do, like I said, they do that all the time.
No big deal. Appreciate your help. I wish I had known, I would have moved it myself. It would have been an interesting video, though, to try to get that trailer snaked out of there sideways. Okay, let me get the position here. As soon as he pulls forward, I'll back in. Gonna start. Uh-oh. Well, that's not a good sign. Kind of tempted to try to go in sideways on that trailer and see if I can't do this myself. By the time he walks back, tell you what, let's go look and see what, has it got dead batteries or something? Let's go look and see what the issue is real quick. Be nosy. Oh, there's no key. He took the key with him. It's 13 speed manual. God, this brings back a lot of memories. I had a T660, but the W900, the interior is identical to the T660. Pretty much. See, that's still a good fifth wheel right there they can take off and use again. There's parts on here that are still good. This axle's probably good. Well, no. I see the pumpkin is all half gone. But there's parts they can peel off some of these wrecked out things and use again. Look at all these fuses. They're still good if they didn't get rained on. Pull all those fuses and put them in a sandwich bag and seal it up. See? Scavenge. It's another old KW over here. I want to go look at it. super single. I was surprised to see that. I assume it's a caterpillar, but can't really tell. These Detroit Series 60s are supposed to be super reliable. That's why they don't junk them out. They can rebuild it. They can put it, they rebuild it, put it back together, and they can put it in what's called a brand new truck with a used engine. It's called a, there's a word for it. Somebody help me. Those kit trucks, they're called something. Yeah, I say it says runs. You just need some work. But they'll sell these engines, they'll put them in a brand new chassis, brand new truck, but with a used, rebuilt engine. They're not legal for California, but they're legal for 48 states. 49, probably 49 states. Yeah. Forget the word that it's called. Well, do you guys want to try? You want to try to hook into this trailer sideways? I have to come in about 90 degrees. I have to get out a couple times, make sure my kingpin is lined up on the slot of my fifth wheel. Come in sideways right here, perpendicular, 90 degrees right here, right about here. It's a question of if they left this trailer tractor forward enough that I can get in the center of that kingpin, if I can click into it and drag it out of here, we'll be in business. Because I don't know where that guy went. He didn't say anything to me. As far as, hold on a minute, I got to go do something, or I got to, you know, he didn't say anything at all. So I have no idea. Just don't know, man.